Good evening, everyone. Welcome to this webinar session of ours today. We have a special session of 15 minutes before starting of webinar. I invite our president of ASN, Dr. Vikram Desai, to start the proceedings today. Vikram, sir.
Yeah. Hello, good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Welcome to this webinar. And we have a very wonderful news today. We will be launching our ASN website, which has been fully revamped, reworked, and it will be introduced in a new format, which will be very user-friendly. And it will be visible from your mobile, from your laptop, or PC, wherever you want. You can open and go through the details. So all the rest of the details will be told to you by Atish. And then I will request our senior past resident, Dr. Prashant Rahate, to unveil or release this ASN website by clicking on the launch button. Atish will let you know about the details soon. So welcome to this interesting webinar. And first we will launch our ASN website, and then that will be followed by the webinar. So thank you so much. The hard work is entirely done by Dr. Atish, all collecting all the data, sending it, corrections, everything. And he has been very ably supported by Dr. Prasad Bansod and Dr. Vikrant Akulwar, who have helped immensely in developing this website. So a big thank you to all of you and all members for promptly responding and sending in all the details, especially the past presidents and all the EC members. So the new look ASN website is ready for you. We will launch it soon. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Vikram, sir. Atish, how we go ahead?
Yes, sir. You click on your email, please.
Surface or use of anti-fog solution. So recently, one study has indicated that they have done the randomized comparison of the laparoscopic lens defogging using anti-fog solution, warm saline, and chlorhexidine solution. And they have come to the conclusion that use of warm saline leads to significantly fewer fogging events than the use of anti-fog solution or chlorhexidine solution, resulting in improved continuity of surgery. So warm saline is the best alternative to prevent the fogging during surgery. Now coming to the camera, which is most important and vital part of our laparoscopic unit, which consists of objective lens and chip. Now everybody should know what is mean by single chip and what is mean by three chip camera. These are very commonly used terminology. So the single chip is when the three primary colors are processed by the same chip, and three chip is separate chip for each primary color. So three chip camera is always better than single chip camera for resolution and the quality of the image. Then what is mean by this HD, HD or a full HD? So depending upon the resolution of the image produced, it is standard definition. These are the vertical resolution. This horizontal resolution is of 640 and the vertical resolution is 480 in the case of standard definition. And in high definition, it is 1280 is the horizontal resolution and 720 is the vertical resolution. So as the vertical resolution increases, the quality of images improves. So even if in HD or full HD, the ratio is 16:9, but as the this vertical resolution is more, you will get a good quality of image. So as compared to HD, the HD provides much better resolution, decreased distortion, and greater depth of field. So everybody should know what is meant by this HD and HD, and your concept should get clear. Now coming to the light source, there are various light sources available. Initially, we used to use halogen, then xenon, and nowadays it's an era of using LED, that is light emitting diode. So why we are preferring now this LED light source in spite of it is more cost? Because it is having low maintenance, it is having long functional life. You will get a natural light like a natural daylight. The long life of more than 30,000 hours as compared to 500 hours of the xenon. Then user selected intensity variation you will get in LED. There is low energy consumption, high efficiency, and very low heating in the case of LED light source. there is no harmful radiation of infrared or ultraviolet to the operating staff and the staff in the operating room, and it is environmentally friendly. So that's why LED is the preferred light source. Coming to the light cables, we are using the fiber optic cables, which are more user friendly, though these are fragile. But as these are more user friendly, it should be handled with care. And if there is more than 25% of damage, we have to replace these cables. Then monitor is a very, very important part of your laparoscopic equipment, because in the monitor, if you get a more natural image in tune with the human anatomy and with a panoramic view, it is always better for a surgeon. And to achieve the full benefit of this HD imaging and maximize the performance, the monitor performance must match the camera head resolution. This point is very, very important. You cannot take the monitor as you like. So it should support the resolution of the camera. So monitor should be compatible with the camera. So again, HD means this much is the resolution that you will get in the monitor. And for full HD, you will get the resolution of 16:9. So commonly we are using 26 to 28 inches monitor for our laparoscopic setup. And ideally, you should have two monitors, as I have already told you. So when you will go for optics, what you should prefer? You should prefer three-chip camera with high definition. You should have a LED light source preferably, and you should have a HD monitor. Now coming to the recording equipment, it is also very, very important part. There are so many inbuilt recording equipment, or you can have a outside recorder or a DVD recorder. So it is not only useful in medical legal procedures, but simultaneous recording, if you get, you can present your work in the conferences. That is one aspect. Then you can grab the images, you can edit the images. So you should have this editing software. You can give the patient CD of whatever operation that you have done for insurance purpose. And you are having your own personal library. Suppose there is some complication occur, so you can review your own videos. And if you have made some mistake in an earlier period, then you can improve on it. So it is for self-assessment also. Now coming to the next important point is how you will do the insufflation. So there are various gases that can be used. The commonly used gases are carbon dioxide. So you should always have a CO2 cylinders in your operation theater. So it has the advantage of being rapidly absorbed by the blood, which is non-toxic, cost-effective, and can be used with the cautery. The insufflator delivers gas at a flow rate of 20 liters per minute, and level is usually set at 12 to 15 millimeters of mercury. Now in this COVID era, there is a role for gasless laparoscopy. It can be performed with the use of mechanical lifting arm that attaches to a fan-like retractor along the peritoneal surface of the abdominal wall. And this has some theoretical advantage in some high-risk patients with compromised cardiorespiratory function. If you are having it, it's well and good. It can be useful in such these areas. Then instruments for the access. There are various types of instruments which are available. The Veres needle, that is the most commonly preferred access, which is the blind approach, which is placed in a closed fashion. Then Hessen's cannula, which is used for getting the initial access to the abdominal cavity with an open cut down technique. And this one is the optical trocar, which allows the visualization of the tissue as the blood cuts through the layers of the abdominal wall. And another this access, that is the open technique, totally open technique. You can take a small incision and directly by open access you can put the trocar. Then coming to the operative instruments, disposable and reusable instruments. Now the disposable instruments have a better performance because of their sharpness and the higher safety, as these are already in a pre-sterilized pack from the industry. So there are very minimum chances of infection that you can get with the disposable instrument. The reusable instruments, these are beneficial, but the cleaning and maintenance is the big issue. But as there is no question of any labor cost in India, so it is better to go ahead with the reusable instruments. And in the case of disposable instrument, again, there is a problem of how to dispose of these instruments because how biodegradability is a big question in a case of disposable instruments. Then coming to the operative instruments, the trocars, The trocar, these are available in various diameters and sizes according to requirement, that is 10 mm, 5 mm, which are the most commonly used. Then there are various tips of the trocars, like pyramidal, conical, or blunt trocars. But the mostly preferred, you should use the conical, though it looks sharp, but it causes least trauma if it is in a control, if you are this using it in a controlled fashion. Then again, as the hand instruments, the trocars are also reusable and disposable trocars. Commonly, we are using reusable trocars. Then hand instruments, you should have replacements ready. Nowadays, there are various hand instruments where grip and the operating tip can be interchangeable. And this sheath remains the same, but you can change the grip and the tip of the instrument depending upon the type of dissection. And always you should have a second set ready, because if there is an instrument failure, that should not be the cause for conversion. Okay, so you should always have a two instruments in your instrument set. Now the hand instruments, these are the sizes of the hand instruments, which vary from 18 centimeter to 45 centimeter. So the standard size that we are using for an adult patient, it is the 36 centimeter size. The 18 to 25 centimeter we are using for the pediatric age group. 36 centimeter is for our normal healthy adults, and the 45 centimeter are used for the very tall persons or for the obese persons. Okay, so mostly for obesity surgery, the instruments used are 45 centimeters. So what decides the length of the instrument? You should always remember, when you are operating, your half of the instrument is always in the peritoneal cavity and half of the instrument is outside. So type 1 leverage you should be able to maintain. Okay, so the commonest used instruments are of 36 centimeter length. Now, what are the parts of the instrument? It is very, very important to know the various parts, because it is very important for everyone. As I am operating, I am a surgeon, but still I should know how to dismantle and how to reassemble the instrument. It is not the job of a sister or a technician. It is the job of myself. So I should know what are the parts, how to dismantle and how to reassemble the instrument. So the parts are hinges, shaft with insulation, that is insulated outer tube. It is very, very important, because see, your, if your cleaning is not proper, or if you are too harsh in cleaning the instrument in a, make a manual cleaning, there can be point perforations, okay, in this insulated outer tube, and that can be the cause for your electrosurgical failure or the catastrophe because of electrosurgical failure. Then the third part is inner effector part, that is insert, which makes the tip of the instrument. Now, what are the prerequisites for ideal reusable instrument? So when you will purchase the instrument or when you will use the instrument, you should always see that jaws to be adequately elastic to perform the traumatic handling. It should be easy to dismantle and reassemble the instrument. Parts should be interchangeable between the similar instrument. Then cleaning and sterilization should be easy, and simple design with minimum number of hinges and bolts. That should be the criteria for ideal reusable instrument. Now, what are the various type of instruments? These are must to have instruments in your OT. That is traumatic forceps, grasping forceps, scissors, bipolar forceps, monopolar forceps, then retractor, suction instrument, needle holder, loop applicator, clip applicator, tackers, endo anchors, and uterine manipulator. So minimum these instruments you should have in your operation theater. Now coming to the graspers, these are ideal for dissecting and grasping the delicate anatomy. Now, in case of grasper, you will get a grasper of either single action jaw or double action jaw. Okay, if you consider the needle holder, it is having a single action jaw, or it is a single action grasper when more force is required, and the double action when you want to operate in a depth, and if it's a very what you can say careful dissection, not you are supposed to apply the undue force, then in such cases double action jaw is mostly preferred. So this basic thing everybody should know. Then coming to the scissors, there are a variety of scissors for dissecting, mobilizing and cutting the tissue, which include straight and curved types. The hook scissors are used to cut the sutures, tough fibrous tissue. Most of the dissecting scissors are adapters for the diathermy. The hook scissors should always be kept in a view while entering and exiting. So these are this point everybody should remember. And the repeated use of diathermy at the sharp edge may tend to blunt the scissor. So scissor is the most frequently instrument that you have to purchase again and again, because it may get blunt after repeated use. Then the dissectors, there is Maryland dissector, very, very important and basic instrument, and the bipolar forceps. It is also must have instrument in your OT. Then the bipolar forceps, you are having at least one you should have in this, and the hooks, spatulas, and the suction and irrigation cannulas. So these are for sharp dissection, and this is to maintain the cavity, your operating cavity clear. You should have this suction irrigation system. Then the endoretractors, these are 5 mm, 10 mm endoretractors, depending upon the type of surgery that you are doing. At least one you should have. Then bowel and lung clamp, you should have. Then the myoma screw or uterine manipulators, these are all important in a case of hysterectomies, these are required. Then vagina tube and grasper. So all these are the hand, basic hand instruments that you should have. Now the important point, the next important point, you should have a energy sources. So to start with, at least you should have a electrosurgery, monopolar, bipolar. Then ultrasonic nowadays again has become a must to have instrument, and the argon beam coagulation. Okay, so energy sources, there are various types of energy sources like monopolar electrosurgery, conventional bipolar electrosurgery, then advanced bipolar electrosurgery, which includes LigaSure and Ensil, then ultrasonic, this shear, that is harmonic scalpel. Everybody is having nowadays is the harmonic scalpel, in which the most peculiarity of harmonic scalpel, you can use in the vicinity of the vital structures, and it can have a cutting as well as coagulating current, depending upon how much is the flow of the current. And the lateral thermal spread is very, very less or very minimum in case of harmonic scalpel. So it is the safest electrosurgery unit. Then hybrid devices like LigaSure Advanced or Thunderbit. So if you are going for advanced surgery, you should have this. So in LigaSure, you can coagulate the vessel up to, or tackle the vessel up to 7 mm in diameter. Now coming to the next very basic, you can say accessory instrument, it is the Sergitae, or the instruments for tissue approximation and hemostasis. So the laparoscopic ligating suture delivery system. So everybody is aware of this pre-tied sliding knot, which are available in the form of loops and along with the knot pusher. And especially it is used in the case of to tie the or ligate the base of appendix, and to ligate the or to tackle the hernial sac. So you should have this Sergitae in your operation theater. Then coming to the needle holders, depending upon what type of grip you want, this is the advanced needle driver, which is also known as endo stitch, which is a 10 mm disposable suturing device, and it is very easy to use. It has easy introduction, non traumatic needle manipulation, and good security and easy accurate needle placement. Then clip applicators, these are again important instrument that you should have. The disposable clip suppliers contain almost 20 clips, whereas reusable clip appliances carry only one clip at a time. These are the titanium clips, which are popularly known as Lega clips, which are available in three sizes, that is 200, 300, and 400. So commonly use this 300 Lega clip, but in operation theater you should have all the three types of Lega clips. Then the mechanical stapling instruments, the laparoscopic staplers, these are the modifications of the stapling devices of open surgery. These are used for transecting and anastomosing the bowel or transecting the mesentery. Then miscellaneous, we have already discussed the aspiration and irrigation probes, and we should have an aspiration needle also. Then the hand-assisted laparoscopic surgery, if you are going for a colorectal surgery or the urological surgery, you should have this hand access device, which is intended to provide a extracorporeal abdominal access for the surgeon during this surgery, and it is indicated for the laparoscopic procedures where your hand through this hand assisted device, your hand may facilitate the procedure and for extraction of the large specimens. Then the organ extraction devices, this is the commercially available organ extraction device, and you should always make a habit to retrieve the specimen with this organ extraction device. You can have your own modifications with this organ extraction device, but don't remove as it is. You should always use a endo bag or some sort of this device, because What is the importance of this using this? Because if it's a histopath report comes as malignancy, like in laparoscopic cholecystectomy, then your management totally changes. So it is better to use this organ extraction devices. Then the tissue morcellators, the one who are doing this hysterectomies, they should have this tissue morcellators to reduce the size of the resected specimen prior to retrieval. But it may render the pathological examination more difficult. And it is mostly used for laparoscopic myomectomies. Then the space creators, the one who are doing tape. So initially, this was a very fancy this device that we used to use for creating the space when saline are instilled into the pre-shaped balloon inserted into the indented region. Now again, there are some local modifications for creating this space. These are mostly used for laparoscopic extraperitoneal surgeries like PEP, then endoscopic neck surgeries, subfacial endoscopic ligation of perforator veins, or any retroperitoneal surgery. Then the port closure needle and the cobbler needle that you should have for subfacial sutures or for closure of the ports under vision. Now, when you are working in a remote areas, then there can be problem of electricity, like voltage fluctuation, power failure, or limited hours of supply. So what is the solution for this? You should have a voltage stabilizer, you should have a UPS, you should have a generator, and it should allow the simultaneous use of electrocautery and suction machine. That is very, very important. Now, this is very important point. Every surgeon, at least in initial phases, should have an endo trainer for suturing practice. Okay. So because it is laparoscopic surgery, it is all the it's a technical thing. So more and more you practice, the more and more refinement of your movements will become. Okay. So endo trainer, everybody should have endo trainer in the side room of your operation theater. Now the laparoscopic surgery, it's a teamwork. So what is the minimum team required? It is surgeon, assistant surgeon, theater sister, or this OT technician, the circulating nurse, and ward boy. And always remember, whatever surgery, the basic principle of laparoscopic surgery, even if you are having the experience of 20 or 25 years, you should always start the surgery as if you are doing the first surgery. All the protocols should be followed, and the open surgery trolley should be kept ready. You never know what will happen at what time. Okay. And all must be well versed in handling all the equipment. That is also a very, very important point in a case of when you are operating or doing any lap surgery. Now, coming to the very important aspect of this sterilization of equipment and operation theater. So before that, we must know what is meant by sterilization. So it is the process that destroys or eliminates all the microbial life. Then disinfection, it is the process that eliminates many or all the microorganisms except bacterial spores or inanimate objects. And the decontamination, it is the removal of all the pathogenic microorganisms from the object to make them safe to handle or use. So all these three concepts everybody must aware. See, because in disinfection, there are three levels of disinfection: low level, medium level, and high level disinfection. And when you will cleaning the instrument, the decontamination, or before going for sterilization cycle, this contamination should be properly achieved. Now, this is the sterilization cycle. So after using of the instrument, you will transport or take this instrument to your washing place. You will clean them thoroughly. Then you will disinfect them. Then you will inspect them properly. Then you will pack them. Then you will do a proper method of sterilization depending upon the type of equipment. Then transportation, storage, and whenever it will require, you will use those instruments. So this is the complete sterilization cycle, and you should know every minute point regarding each step of this sterilization cycle. So when you will consider the decontamination, it is the combination of the procedures used to make a reusable instrument or atom safe for further use on patients and staff by reducing the bioburden. So it is very, very important to know this concept of decontamination. Now, how you will clean the instrument and who should clean the instrument? Once you operate, your procedure gets finished, you just come out of the OT. And whatever sister is doing behind you, you never know what she is or he is doing. So, but you should be aware and you should have a watch, or you yourself should do the cleaning of the instruments. So it should be always under running tap water, and after cleaning of the instrument, it should be kept in an ultrasonic cleaner. And it is not only the tip of the instrument, but the whole of the hand instrument, you have to dismantle and you have to clean it thoroughly. So what is the cleaning path of this instrument? So once on table, you have used the instrument, you should wipe the instrument, you should keep in a water bowl. So whatever the blood is accumulated in the crevices, that will get loosened up. Or whatever the debris is there, it will get loosened up. Then you should hold the instrument under running water. That will decrease the organic load. Then you have to dismantle the instrument, clean the channels, dip in the detergent and enzymatic solution. Enzol is the most commonly used solution. Clean the channels, joints and serration. It is very, very important to clean this. Otherwise, your sterilization process will totally fail and you may get a typical mycobacterial infection. That is the commonest cause if you don't do proper cleaning. And brush and flush should be the motto. So you should brush with specifically with the nylon brush, nylon soft brush. You should clean the instruments, then you should flush the instrument with the water jet, and then you have to put those instruments in the ultrasonic cleaner for proper washing and drying of the instrument, and then you should send for proper sterilization. So this cleaning path is very, very important to follow to avoid the further consequences of infection. So why it is important, why we are so much elaborating on this cleaning of the instrument? Because this laparoscopic instrument, these are complex design, they are delicate in construction, and because of the positive pressure of carbon dioxide, there can be this tissue or blood, it can get driven into the channels. So to clear up the channels and crevices is very, very important. And the problems arise because of this lodging of the bioreactors in the crevices, and gentlest method need to be used for cleaning and sterilization, especially the joint here. This is the insulated part and this is the metallic part. So this joint, you have to be very, very careful. If there is a poor perforations in this, that can lead to electrosurgical problems, okay, or insulation failure. Now, what are the substances that you are not supposed to use while cleaning the instruments, like saline, bleaching powder, iodine-based preparations, abrasive cleaners like Vim powder, laundry detergents, surgeon's hand scrub or soap, you are not supposed to use while cleaning the instruments. Then coming to the disinfection, I have already told you there is three levels of disinfection, low, intermediate and high. So the low level of disinfection can be used for OT table and flooring of the OT. So you can use with the sodium hypochlorite solution, low level of disinfection. Then the intermediate infection and the high disinfection. What is the high level of disinfection there? It is important. It is important mostly for the scopes or the delicate instruments. Okay. So these are the, depending upon the type of disinfection you want to do, you will have to use either low, intermediate or high level. So what are the various methods of disinfection? It is low temperature steam, that is 73 degree centigrade for 20 minutes, or boiling water or formaldehyde, or glutaraldehyde. Okay, so glutaraldehyde 2%, it is effective against most of the bacteria, viruses including hepatitis B, C, HIV, and degree of disinfection is proportionate to the how much time you are using it. Okay, and the OPA solution is the another type of disinfection that can be used. It is for high level of disinfection, and depending upon this you may go ahead with the sterilization. So factors affecting the efficacy of disinfectant, it is the prior cleaning. So if you have not cleaned your instrument properly, there is no use of any sterilization or proper disinfection. So your cleaning, proper cleaning is the utmost important thing that you are supposed to do while handling your hand instruments. Then the moisture, that's why the instrument should be dry. So if there is a moisture, it will affect your disinfectant process. Then direct contact with the atoms, time of contact and the temperature, all these are the factors which will affect the efficacy of the disinfection. So coming to the sterilization, the dictum is all the instruments entering into the patient body should be autoclaved. Always remember. So there is no shortcut to autoclaving. So only way to avoid a typical mycobacterial infection is to autoclave all the hand instruments. The another important way and the standard method of sterilization is steroid, that is gas plasma sterilization, but the availability and cost is the factor steroid, but ETO is generally available, so ETO is the can be the preferred choice. Then Cydex, it is widely available and everybody is using this Cydex solution. So soak the instruments depending upon whether it is a Cydex, whether it is a Cydex plus, depending upon that how much is the concentration of glutaraldehyde, depending upon that you can use this time and the temperature. So it is mostly 12 minutes, 25 minutes or 40 minutes, and temperature is around 20 to 25 degrees centigrade to achieve the high level of disinfection. So it is almost as good as sterilization. Okay, so if you can use Cydex very safely for your this scopes and everything. Say no to formalin chamber. It is a very, very important point that everybody should remember. No formalin chamber, because there is no standard. The sterilization, the commonest methods that we are using, the autoclaving, that is steam under pressure, 121 degrees centigrade for 15 to 20 minutes and 15 lbs, okay, pressure. Then ETO is the commonest. This autoclave is for hand instruments, ETO for heat sensitive instruments. And very important, there should not be any soiling of the instrument when you will give for the ETO. So for tubings, you will mostly go for ETO instruments, okay. And the gamma irradiation, when you are using, when you are getting already a sterilized pack, pre-sterilized pack, in the industry, they are already, there is already a gamma irradiation. The formalin chamber, it is bane of laparoscopy. So you are not supposed to use this formalin chamber. Okay, so there is so much of pros and this so much of side effects, or what you can say, there are so many disputes, though it is readily available, but there is no standardization regarding this formalin chamber. How much leak is there? How many times you are opening this chamber in 24 hours? How many tablets that you are supposed to keep for achieving the which level of disinfection? How many minutes should be the exposure? How much should be the temperature? And what is our routine practice? You are just keeping or overloading the formalin chamber with the instrument. So don't show the instrument in a chamber and hop from one hospital to another. So you should prevent this for patient safety, and ultimately to this it is your own safety. So for that say no to formalin chamber. So how good is the formalin chamber? See, for spores it has no effect, and for dried soil instruments also it has no effect. So it is better not to use the formalin chamber. What you are supposed to use? The Cydex glutaraldehyde 2%. It is effective. The efficacy depends upon how much is the shelf life. When it is activated, the normal shelf life is 14 days. Then time of contact, it should have minimum 25 to 40 minutes of contact. There should be complete submergence of the instrument. Number of cycles, instrument, whether it is wet or dry, amount of bioburden, how much is the pH of Cydex and temperature. So efficacy of this Cydex depends upon all these factors. So as we are, it is the commonly used solution for disinfection or sterilization. So we should aware that before using or putting the instrument in Cydex, the instrument should be thoroughly clean and dry the instrument. Because why it should be dry? Because water on the instrument, it changes the pH of the Cydex. Then use the sterilized stainless steel tray for the Cydex and avoid the plastic tray. Check the efficacy before use. Allow the Cydex to drip back into the tray. Use gloves hands to pick up the instrument. The lifter should not touch the tray wall because it is unsterile. Then rinse the instrument thoroughly in sterile water. That is also very, very important. How much hurry in you are? You are supposed to rinse the instrument at least 3 times before using. Then sterilize the sterile water tray also and dry all the instruments before use. Okay. So even if you are taking the instrument of the Cydex, you are supposed to follow all these very basic things. The plasma sterilization, sterilizer is the best. But the availability and cost is the issue. So when you will consider how to, which sterilization method you should opt for. So for camera, you should use the Cydex or gas plasma if it is available. Then light cable, you can use Cydex. For telescope, you can do the autoclaving or you can use the Cydex. Okay. Then for this tubing and diathermy, you should use the ETO. For harmonic scalpel cable, you can use the Sidex. For heat sensitive hand instrument, you should use the ETO or Sidex. Again, for heat resistant hand instruments, the autoclave is the best. Okay, then you can again use this ETO. And the for trochars, you should go ahead with the autoclaving. So these are the basic things that everybody should know. Now this is data what it suggests, that steam sterilization is the first choice for heat tolerant endoscopes and accessories. Then heat sensitive endoscopes and accessories, you should go for ETO, gas plasma sterilization, or insufficient instruments or time to or insufficient time for sterilization, especially if you are in conferences or if there is too much of workload in OT. Then what you are supposed to do, immersion in the 2% glutaraldehyde, and it should be at least 10 minutes and more than 20 minutes if mycobacterial infection is suspected, and it should be at least 3 hours to kill all the spores. So these are the points that everybody should remember. Now what is our aim? Our aim of minimal access surgery, you should give a good cosmesis. Okay, so the final result should not be like this because of your faulty cleaning, faulty disinfection, or faulty sterilization of the instruments. Now again, this nosocomial tubercular infection, it is a totally avoidable situation. Okay, it is all in your hand, whether if you are having a proper sterilization technique, you can avoid this nosocomial tubercular infection as well as a typical mycobacterial infection. So during or about the sterilization, everybody should aware what is right. Are we doing it right? What are the consequences of not doing it right? And how can we do it right? So these are the important points during about the sterilization of the laparoscopy instruments. Now this is the data. It is very shocking data in spite of knowing all these things, though this data is from 2002. But I think the situation is almost, there may not be much change in the situation. The formalin chamber is the, almost it is used by 49% of the surgeons. The Sidex is used by 44%, ETO only by 2%. There may be the question of availability of the ETO and the autoclaving, though it is widely available, but there is no concept of autoclaving the hand instruments. Okay, it is very easy to put in the Sidex. So only 4% surgeons are using the autoclave. And I think it is almost similar situation, but it should change. So what are the points to remember regarding the sterilization? Thorough cleaning is an important primary step. Essential to follow the rigid protocols for this cleaning and sterilization of the instruments. Only well-established method of sterilization or high level of disinfection should be used. Some current practices should be abolished, like formalin chambers or reuse of the disposable instrument. Again, it's a very important point to discuss, reuse of the disposable instruments, because see, this disposable instrument, you cannot wash them thoroughly, and there are always a chances of insulation failure when you will clean those instruments. So it is better not to reuse the disposable instruments. And it is necessary to establish a stringent regulation for the instrument manufacturers. So what is your requirement? It is better to have, it's a very general point, but what I think, you should always have an affiliation to recognize medical bodies when you are start your practicing laparoscopy, and you should always have a professional indemnity insurance, because you never know what will happen when. Okay, so it is always you should have an affiliation to the recognized medical bodies. So to conclude, you should have a good setup, you will enjoy your work. Lab surgery, it is always a teamwork, and always when you are at least in the initial practice, or as it is a, why it is known as teamwork, because see, you never know when you will require help. So you should always have some standby experienced surgeon, may not be senior, he may be junior to you, but he can help you out in your emergency situations. Then you should have patience, because especially in case of bleeding, if you lose your patient, there can be catastrophe. So you should have patience, select the proper patient in initial phases. Lab surgery is here to say, so here to stay. So there is no option than learning or going for laparoscopic surgery. So learn it and have a good setup of laparoscopic surgery. Then above all, do no harm. That is our basic principle. That is primum de nocere. So you should do no harm to the patient. And if in doubt, don't be afraid to convert to open. That is very, very important thing. It should not be your ego that you are converting the patient. It is for your own safety and patient safety. You should always follow the principles of ergonomics. It's very, very important. And have a regular exercises. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you very much. Now I request Rahate sir to begin the question answer session.
It was a perfect lecture by a perfect professor. All details have been tackled. All details they have been tackled beautifully, and complete details have been taken care of in this particular lecture. I will highlight some thing here. Developing
yes,
team.
Sir.
Yeah, developing team is at most important, and that will bring more success to your practice.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes. You should have a rescue surgeon, a senior surgeon, the mentor,
yes,
surgeon, mentor surgeon, or a surgeon who is well versed in that particular specialty. You should always inform that particular surgeon friend that you are going to do that surgery, and he should be available for the rescue. And your OT team should be perfect, because that OT team is going to take care of your instruments, and it can save, that team can save a lot of money for you if the instruments are taken care. And regarding the height of the table, nowadays the concept is coming up that surgeon is sitting comfortably and operating, so the height of the table should be minimum.
Yes,
the height of the monitor. I will share a personal experience here that I was keeping the monitor height above my neck level, so I had to look up during all my operating career. So last year I had a cervical spine got operated.
Yes.
So that ergonomics is very important. One thing I will also like to highlight, in the era of this COVID infection, we have to take a lot of precautions during our surgeries, and we have to modify various instrumentation. Even the anesthesia machine is to be modified. The gas insufflation is to be modified. How the gas is to be spelled out, that is to be modified. Regarding sterilization, you have rightly mentioned there is no role of formalin chamber. That is the rule. And again, the insufflation, instead of 20 liters, one should go in for 45 liters minimum.
Okay.
Because in the event of bleeding, you go on suction. Once you suction it with the 20 liters.
Yes, sir. High flow you have to use.
Everything.
That period. Yes.
And collapses. So suction is very important if you want to tackle the bleeding. So therefore the 45 liter capacity of this thing is very important. So suctioning simultaneously with the surgical procedure is very important. So ultimately it was a fantastic lecture. Thank you very much, madam, for
sir,
all that details.
Meenakshi ma'am and Rahate sir, please share your webcams also, because we don't have any screen right now running. Ajay sir, Singhania sir, any comments? Your mic is muted, sir. Please unmute from your side. Yeah, now.
Yeah,
no,
Rajesh,
you're not audible, sir. Now please try. No, we are not listening to you, sir. Sir, you can we had your voice till now. I don't know what is happening. By that time I'll take any question from attendees. Yeah, you can log in through your mobile till that time, sir. Dr. Vikas Jain sir has a question. Vikas sir, please unmute yourself.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello. Good evening, ma'am. Vikas, sir. Hello. Madam, yeah, nice talk. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Madam, it was nice talk. Almost all the points are covered. Madam, I just want to ask one thing. You have told you should not use the disposable instrument reused. So what about the harmonic scalpel, madam? They say it is single use, but most of the time we use for 10 times, 12 times. That is commonly yes, we sir, do.
Yes, sir. Sir, it is mostly applicable for the hand instruments where insulation is the problem. It is mostly
we can modify this statement, madam.
Okay, okay.
You see the manual of the harmonic scalpel in detail, they have allowed etio sterilization of the instruments. They have even allowed steriad, that is the plasma sterilization of the instruments, and you can very well do ETO and or plasma sterilizer if it is available and reuse it.
Okay, sir. So now it is officially we can say also yes. In field also. Yes.
Yes.
Okay, sir. And madam, one more question I have. Can we do almost all the instrument and everything can we sterilize on ETO, madam?
Yes, sir. Hand instruments also can be sterilized by ETO.
And camera, madam? Camera.
Camera also.
Camera.
Rahat sir can highlight on this.
Yeah, because there yes, are sir. Two types of ETO sterilization. One is hot ETO sterilization and one is less hot, that is the cold ETO sterilization. See, all these delicate instruments, they can be sterilized at the lower temperature. They can
okay.
be sterilized at lower temperature, but they can be safely ETO sterilized.
Sir, is there is any specification? Because in our ETO sterilizer, once you lock the machine, it will only open after the 8 to 9 hours once the sterilization is complete. So we can't able to adjust the temperature.
No. Temperature can be adjusted in all ETO machines. You can go ahead and reach that one. And the time needed is more than 8 hours. Always.
After 8 to 9 hours only, it opens up once the sterilization is complete.
Yes. So at the beginning itself, we can adjust the temperature of the.
Okay.
Yeah, we have Singhania sir online through mobile.
Hello.
Thank you, madam. Thank you, madam.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Loud and clear.
Yes. Okay. So it was a very good lecture, madam.
Thank you.
Few points. One can compromise on OT or OT table, but one should have a very good instruments and lenses. Right? Secondly, if you are doing hernia surgery, then I will suggest that one should have two sets of instrument. One for hernia surgery, which should be an autoclavable instruments. And for hernia surgery, all instruments should be autoclaved. Then checking of the insulations are very much important. The surgeon should check on the instruments so that there cannot be any accident and he will be very safe. Secondly, if you are using a cautery and if you are pushing a pad and if the current is not seen, it means the current is leaking somewhere and one should stop immediately. These are my few suggestions which can make a surgeon safe laparoscopy yes. surgery. Thank you, madam. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
There is one small tip how to recognize a small leak in the current in the insulation. If you overlook the hole in the insulation, then you will get a small sparking sound when you are doing the cauterization. So loud music in OT loud sounds in OT, they are to be avoided, because this thing will change your life.
Now I understand, sir. Why you never play music in your OT Rahate, sir. Long surgeries, you never play music. So we have next question from Ranjita Nayak. I have unmuted your mic. Please unmute yourself and ask your question. Ranjita Nayak. Yeah, next in line, Dr. Sanjay Ghate, sir, please unmute yourself.
Good evening, madam.
Good evening, sir, good evening.
And, I just want to add one thing. After washing the instrument and cleaning with the brush, I use the pressurized air that we as a urologist have for the intracorporeal lithotripsy.
Yes, sir.
Pressurized air cleans the channels of the
channels
very well, and I want to comment on the.
Sir, your voice is not audible, sir, please. Sanjay, sir, I can't listen to you completely.
Yeah, point well taken. Yeah, point well taken, Sanjay. The moisture in the instrument should not be there. One more thing to be kept in the mind, if we are doing ETO sterilization, it should be without any moisture. The instrument should be without any moisture, because hydrogen peroxide combined with the ETO gas will form a very highly carcinogenic agent.
Yeah.
And therefore, again, the moisture should not be there in the system.
Okay. This is my personal experience that after cleaning with pressurized air, the infection rate is certainly very less.
Thank you. Thank you for that input, Sanjay sir. Next question is from Dr. Sunil Mapari sir. Mapari sir, please unmute yourself.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good evening, madam. Very nice, elaborative lecture. Everything is covered. I think the same question Dr. Sanjay Ghate has covered, that tubings, the sheath of the hand instruments, they have to be dried with the compressed air. I think he has covered that thing. Compressed air is the best solution. You can clean the inner part of the tubings. Yes, yes. As well as hand instrument sheath also. That is the prerequisite for the ETO sterilization. That just now Dr. Prashant Rahate sir has covered that topic also. No?
Thank you. Sorry. Sunil sir, please unmute yourself.
Am I audible now?
Yeah.
Initially you told ki there should be two monitors at the head end. But many times. Many times simultaneously, if you want to do give the pelvic wash at that time, other monitor should be at the foot end also.
Yes, so minimum two monitors should be there. So that is,
the third one should be at the when we give the wash in the pelvic area. Na? That is my little suggestion, madam. That will make you comfortable. Otherwise, you have to turn every time when the monitor is towards the head end.
Yes. Next question from Dr. Anup Paliwal. Next question from Dr. Anup Paliwal. Please unmute yourself, Anup. Dr. Anup, yeah.
Yes, sir. Am I audible?
Yeah.
Good evening, madam.
Good evening.
Madam, excellent presentation, ma'am. I heard everything.
Thank you.
Ma'am, just a small query, ma'am. Generally, the laparoscopy hand instrument, the jaws get stuck when you use repeatedly, or scissors loses its sharpness. Anything specific care to be taken to avoid that, ma'am?
No, for scissors, you have to change the scissors. That is the only thing. And for stacking of jaws, if your cleaning is not proper, that that can be the reason, or rusting can be one of the reasons. I think Rahate sir can make a comment on this.
No, there is no compromise, because the scissors will have a definite life of the instrument.
Yes.
And that is the reason why many of the companies, they are coming up with the set of 10 inserts for the scissor. Even the Stars company has came up with the similar offer. One scissor is costing more than 30,000-40,000, but 10 inserts, one single handle, they are giving it at only 1.5 lakhs. So 10 scissors, you can use it for at least 3-4 years. So that is a particular life for that particular instrument, and you will not compromise on that.
Thank you. Thank you.
Ma'am, I have a query. Many a times we see in laparoscopic videos, I have not personally used, people use scissor with cautery. I mean, when doing LAR or APR, the peritoneal reflections and all are taken care with cautery as well as scissor, which is used combined. Can it decrease the shelf life of scissor? Decreases, I guess, the shelf life of scissor.
Yes.
It will definitely decrease the life of the scissor.
Okay. So right now I don't have any other hand being raised or any other questions from audience. So at this point, I guess we should have a concluding remarks.
Yogesh, I have one question. Yogesh.
Yeah, sorry, sir. Yeah. You had asked a question. Ma'am, what is the role of smoke evacuator in present day COVID-19 era? Smoke evacuators. That's a question.
Actually,
from
I don't have much experience. Actually, we don't have in our OT. So I think Rahate sir must be having experience on this. Sir, please, you can comment on this.
Ultimately, Atish, the smoke evacuators, they will decrease the smoke in the vicinity of the surgeon. But the smoke evacuator have exhaust, which will be opening in the OT itself. So it is better to give a small, apply a small tube to the one of the hand port.
Okay.
So that you open the tube, open the exit channel of that particular port, and that tube is attached to a container with sodium hypochlorite solution. That is the simplest way, which have been suggested by AMASI, which has been suggested by even SAGES also. And regarding the exhaust of the, because the patient's exhaled air will be circulating in the from that particular anesthesia machine into the OT environment itself. So even the all the anesthesia stations, they are having an exhaust, which is at the back of the instrument, back of the anesthesia machine. So a small tube should be applied to that particular exhaust, and that should be again released into the sodium hypochlorite solution. One care should be taken that the sodium hypochlorite solution level should not be more than 3 inches. If more than 3 inches, the back pressure develops into the pulmonary area, because the exhaust will be having some resistance because of that. So okay, this is the simplest way to avoid contamination in COVID area from the anesthesia machine and from your end also.
And that also is it. Sir, one more thing I want to ask. What is your take on the machine by CONMED, in which it does not allow air leak and air insufflation, and CO2 pressure is kept maintained in it? So what is your take in this present COVID-19 era on that machine?
Even the CONMED is having the exhaust, which opens up into the OT.
That opens up in the machine, means that I have used that equipment about 3-4 times.
But that machine is having a exit also.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah, Singhani, sir. Yeah.
The smoke evacuator which Stars is having, opening goes into the suction machine.
Okay.
It does not open in OT. It opens in the suction machine.
suction machine.
It will go in the central suction.
Central suction is not available, then that will go into the.
That will go in. Yeah. And what about, sir, that CONMED equipment which does not allow leakage of air and maintains the CO2 pressure?
I don't have any.
It is good, but it is also having an exhaust.
Yeah.
So they have now come up with that same idea of today microperchlorate.
Okay.
So, sir, just a question extending to this. We have seen COVID since March now, and it's been June. The earlier reports that there are peritoneal fluids and aerosols which are generated in laparoscopy, which are very high and harmful. Is it really true? Because contrary reports have now come up, which have shown that there is no COVID virus which is seen in the laparoscopic gas or the peritoneal fluid. So is what was it really a hype which was created in March, the fear which was generated in our mind, or is it really true?
Difficult to comment because every now and then we are getting some new thing. The old protocols getting cancelled and the new protocols being put forward. So yeah. Still, I think everybody is in a learning stage and getting new experiences. So it is very difficult to model dogmatically.
Yeah, we have a last question from Dr. Santosh Somani, sir. If he can unmute his mic and ask, or else he has typed a question, I'll ask him directly. Santosh sir, you can unmute your mic and ask the question. Yes sir, please go ahead. Yes sir, we can listen to you. Go ahead.
Yeah. Is there any role of alcohol for sterilization of tubing or instrument?
No.
Hello?
I don't think, sir. I don't know about it.
No.
Okay.
No role.
Prashant sir.
No role.
There is no role of. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Meenakshi ma'am, for that elaborative talk and a very nice discussion which we had after that.
Yes.
Thank you, Rajesh sir and Rajesh Singhania sir, for being the panelists today. Have our clinical meet next week. We'll have our clinical meet. Very important. Very beautiful. Three cases will be discussed. So we'll put up the link and all the details very soon. Thank you very much. Good night.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
One more thing. This was our 52nd webinar. We have already crossed 50. When we crossed 50, even I don't remember. This is 52nd webinar which is going on. We have crossed half century.
Really? Congrats.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good night, sir. Yeah, good night.